And now they face their fate. It's an all-new American Idol. Fox.
The second round of American Idol began 2 days ago when 117 contestants arrived from all over the country.
Hola, LA.
Some worked hard in Hollywood.
I came here to win. I don't lose. I win.
Others were seduced by the glamour.
There are some cute guys that... Alan, the model. You can't help but notice.
After 2 days of intensive auditioning, 30 contestants were cut.
The competition has ended for you tonight. We're not going to ask you to go forward. I'm sorry.
Kira Bivens in particular did not take it well.
What do you think they're looking for?
It's beyond me now. Maybe somebody who's stupid. Maybe trailer trash this year, you know, maybe some American Idol trailer trash. I don't know.
The remaining 87 contestants were then asked to perform in groups. Rehearsals did not go smoothly.
I didn't pick my group. I don't know them. I don't even remember their names.
I guess I'm practicing by myself for the rest of the night because my crew, they left.
The one girl's mom is up there and she's pissing me off.
Tonight, the judges must decide on their finalists, one of whom will become your next American Idol. Pasadena, California. The remaining 87 contestants arrived to begin day three of the competition. No one really knows how it will turn out, but everyone's got an opinion.
My prediction is that I'm not going home. I'm here to stay.
Regardless of who comes in first, we're in the top three.
90% of them will forget the words.
I am planning to be the youngest person in the top 32.
We're going to be great.
95% of them won't sing a note in tune.
I'm going all the way to number one.
I really have a good feeling about that.
Let me explain what today will end up as. A musical car crash.
Well, things aren't bad at the moment with the contestants determined to enjoy themselves. They even named their groups.
Divas in Red, I thought was right.
Oh, nice. Divas in Red.
Divas in Red. Oh, do you see this?
We're the Ghetto Fab Four.
I don't know. I'm not ghetto.
But we could be the Fab Four.
I'm not ghetto.
There's suburban funk right there.
The Bleach Boys.
Got the highlights going on.
We got dark, middle, light.
So Peroxide brought those guys together, but it was the Aloha spirit that bonded our Hawaiians, although Randy felt the bonds would soon be broken.
I love all the ones that say, you know, this is my family here. I've made so many friends. Oh, yeah, your friends all want you to win, too, I bet.
Well, there really is a family here, the Roman brothers.
I'm not gonna let him win.
Actually, I'm not gonna give him a chance either.
And I know he's not gonna let me win.
If I have to, I'll cut his throat.
Yeah, sounds like they've been taking advice from Simon's book on idol etiquette. And of course, he's always got something to say.
I just want to say a few words before we start. Don't forget the words. Please do not forget the words.
Don't forget the words.
So with that final piece of sarcastic advice guaranteed to psych them out, it's time to start the morning auditions. First up was our Hawaiian trio singing Up on the Roof.
When this old world starts getting me down, I feel like there's no much for you to say.
Up on the roof,
there the world below can follow me. I'll keep on telling you.
Right smack dab in the middle of town, found a peaceful place that's trouble-proof.
Up on the roof.
I kind of like the little pizzazz thing you guys had going on. Looks like you rehearsed it, the steps. The harmonies actually were probably better than the leads, but it was all right, dude. It was all right.
Thanks.
All right, thanks.
Thank you, Randy.
I think this was a great way to start off today. I mean, really, really
thank
good.
Thank you.
Mahalo. Yeah,
mahalo.
Your harmonies were really beautiful.
Just really soothing and fun. The three of you have a great little chemistry there. Good job.
Thank you. I appreciate it, Mahalo.
I sort of agree. I think it was a reasonable start. You know, you were just three okay singers singing okay.
So that's actually good for Simon, so.
Yeah.
We'll take that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mahalo once again.
A good start. Could it get better? Well, the next group thought so.
I wish we were first.
Yeah.
I think we'd set the pace.
Boom.
A lot of,
the crew,
you know,
that's all I gotta say.
Has being one of Simon's favorites gone to Michael Cowan's head?
If I don't win it, then I will definitely come within the top three.
Michael Cowan, doesn't it sound good? It looks good, it sounds good. I think it'll work, don't you think?
Let me tell you about a right smack dab in the middle of town. I found a paradise that is me.
I'm on the roof.
And now I don't know why this is rude.
When this old world starts getting you down, and people are just too much for me to face.
On the roof. And if this world starts getting you down, there's room for two up on the roof.
Wow. 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 I think that was really terrible. You forgot the words. I don't know what. This is like a bad Love Boat performance. Like I'm on a cruise ship. I'm drunk. I don't know where I am, what I'm doing, and I'm listening to some people sing. That was not very good, though.
Well, I know you all have seen me do a lot better than that.
Yeah.
And I'm 100%.
Yeah. Guys, it wasn't great. Sorry to say, it wasn't great.
I'll tell you what I thought. It was absolutely ghastly with a capital G. There was no star quality, there was no edge. I mean, I expected all of you to end with a wink. I mean, I'm serious. Terrible. Thank you very much.
All right, wait, though. You have seen me in the past, and you know what I can do. Just because of this song, I do not want you to judge me based solely on this song. Please.
I don't think you're going to be alone in that sentiment. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.
And he wasn't. So as Michael tried to keep his ego afloat, the rest of the boys sank like the Titanic.
Give it up. You haven't heard. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna turn you off and hurt you. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna take you out and desert you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I don't know what happened. You know, that never happens to me. I don't know what happened.
It was tough for Noel, but even tougher for his brother Jesus to sit in the audience and watch.
I felt he should have did much better because he had the group support with him. I don't know, he let me down, you know? He kind of let me down.
Jesus also felt let down last night by his group, Matt and George.
We didn't practice at all. As a group, we didn't practice. Everybody wanted to go to sleep, except for me. I wanted to practice. They were tired.
Despite the lack of group rehearsal, it's up to Jesus to restore the family pride.
We're no strangers to love. Wanna let you down.
hurt you. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you.
Well, well, definitely entertaining, definitely entertaining. Yo, George, man, I like the fact that you put the hat on, man. You try and make you look a little younger.
You
got the bees jumping on.
I'm young. I'm young.
Dude, what? Jesus, man, what's up, baby?
Yo, I was up mad late practicing.
Man, dog, it didn't show at all.
Man, I was working by myself all night and all that.
And then you got
everybody went to sleep. I was just up like till 4 o'clock in the morning. And
for him to get up and kind of pawn it off on us, like, well, the group. I'm not saying I had my best performance, but me and George didn't forget our lines. How's that a group thing?
Well, maybe Matt and George didn't forget their lines, but many did.
Listen, boy, don't let me get in anything that way. You know I don't like anything of the rain inside today.
Needless for me to say, it was terrible.
Hello, I didn't even know who you were.
If you sang like that in a karaoke bar, they turn the power off.
So the boys went down in flames. Join us after the break when the girls are red hot.
Young hearts, to yourself be true. Don't be no fool. Love really don't love you.
But it's not long before they freeze.
I kind of love you, say. But it's just time to...
Wednesday afternoon, and it's almost time for the girls' auditions. They don't want to make the same mistakes as the boys and forget their lyrics, so they're making use of every second and every trick in the book.
Call me my mama said you...
But nothing's gonna help you if you lose a group member.
Where is our third member? That has been the story of the day.
They came in here looking for you. Where's Meliana? You better go look for your group, girl.
I'm gonna go try and find her one more time, ask if she's gonna come down, and if not, then that's it.
Well, they may have lost Meliana, but Leah Vladowski's group has found a coach.
This is our manager. Bulgarian queen.
Oh, yes, sure. Bulgarian pop star manager.
Yes, her mother.
I was a very famous pop star in Bulgaria, actually, in the 70s when I was young.
She's working with us like crazy.
Yeah, she's chopping us.
Chop, chop, let's get this done. Yeah.
She just gave us five.
Yeah, we get a break.
She just gave us our first break. We've been working all night.
Well, teamwork has certainly helped them, but for some reason, Meliana is doing everything she can to avoid her group.
There she is. And she's leaving.
Who knows what's going on there? It's too late to worry about it anyway. The judges are back, and first up are Leah, Elizabeth, and Dina.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Young hearts, to yourself be true. Don't be no fool. Love really don't love you. You just can't break away. Just can't break away. Young hearts, run free. Never be hung up for my man and me. Oh, oh, oh. Young hearts, to yourself be true. Don't be a fool if love really don't love you.
What a difference a gender makes. The first group of girls on fire.
I appreciate it. Now, that's the way you do it if you're really trying to do something. Creative steps, creative singing. All three of you could sing. It was a good group. The backgrounds, the harmonies.
Amen, amen, amen. Proud of you. Excellent.
Thanks, guys. Thank you very much.
I think we may have a top 12 full of girls this year.
Amen.
And I couldn't care less if we don't have any guys in the competition. Thank you. Well done.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Backstage, Meliana has finally joined her group, and with almost no rehearsal, they must face the judges.
I need love, love to ease my mind. I need to find someone to call my. But my mama said, can't hurry love. No, you just have to wait. She said, love don't come easy. It's just a part of give and take.
Sitting behind the desk, I've always got one eye on the audience, and I see their glee when someone is forgetting the words. It's like, good, another one's gone, and then it's kind of like, camera's on me, I look sympathetic now. That's tough, man. That's tough. Whereas deep down, they're thinking, fantastic, another one's just screwed up.
After that performance, it's Courtney and Janine who want to avoid Meliana. But they weren't the only group with a weak link in the chain.
I'll be very honest with you. Three of us are very strong, and Lana is probably the weakest of the four of us. She says she's very tired. A lot of us are tired. So I think it's just a matter of knowing how to pick it up and not let the tiredness work against you.
I know something about love. You gotta want it bad. If that guy's got into your blood, you gotta get him. If you want him to be a very part of you,
that makes you wanna breathe. Here's the thing to do. You gotta tell him that you're never gonna leave him. Tell him that you're always gonna love him. Tell him, tell him, tell him, tell him right now.
Lana, what was going on, man?
I got freaked out, and I drew a wall for the words, and I started ad-libbing, and just all this stuff started coming out.
Wow. Notes were all over the place.
Lana, you just had a brain fart. That's all, okay?
One of you lost your way. Two of you sounded like show singers, and one, vocally to me, was in a different league, and that was Sarah. I thought it was one of your best performances.
Thank you.
Actually, Nicole was the best one because the song fit her the best.
Yeah, I agree.
I say, Randy, you were the best one.
That's the first compliment I've gotten from Randy, so I'm going to put that one in my back pocket.
Yeah, baby, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Goodbye.
Ciao.
Goodbye. My goal for Pasadena is to make the transformation from this scooter girl image over to this is Nicole with a big voice and a really big passion to share this gift that she has.
Overall, the day of group performances has not gone well. The judges are losing their patience, and the girls are letting it get to them.
I remember watching the show last year and thinking when I'd watch all those people that forget their words on stage, I was like, how can they forget their words? You know, they're doing American Idol. They have an opportunity of a lifetime. Why aren't they in their bedroom all night long memorizing these words? We are!
As with the boys, there's one thing they cannot conquer. Their nerves.
I need love, love to ease my to find someone, but mama said, no, you just have to wait, but easy, but it's just time to, you can't hurry, love, just have to wait, yeah, just a little time, no matter how long it takes.
Yeah, oh, oh, oh.
Diana Ross and the Supremes, please accept our apologies.
You know, yeah.
No one committed, really. You know, it's like it just... It seemed like you felt defeated completely.
Everything I'm seeing today tells me that maybe this bunch of people aren't ready for this. I mean, it was a complete ragbag performance. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
No.
The possibility of an all-girl top 12 has been shattered by the reality of their performances.
At the end of a very difficult day, the judges now have to make some decisions. Who makes it on to the final day this week and who doesn't?
Just give me boys and girls.
Okay.
Now, no one could possibly predict who would continue in the competition. However, some were feeling confident.
I believe I'll make it to the next cut.
I think I did all right today.
Others were less optimistic.
I think I did really bad today. Really bad.
I don't know if I'm gonna get cut tonight. I really hope not.
I'll probably go home.
When we come back, the journey comes to an end for 30 more contestants.
I'm sorry to say you're going home.
After 2 days and 11 hours of auditioning, it took less than 10 minutes for the judges to cut 30 more people.
Moment of truth. 45215, step forward.
However, as the contestants were asked to step forward, no one knew if they were staying on or going home.
The back line, I'm sorry to say you're going home.
But at other times, they cut the front line.
Front line? Sorry to say, this will be your last night.
And sometimes, the judges just confused everybody, including themselves.
2609, step forward. Congratulations, you all through to the next round.
Sadly, amongst today's casualties was Drea Hancock. Not really surprising if you remember what the judges said at her first audition in Los Angeles.
I don't know how far she'll go, but there's something very different about you that's interesting.
I guess not different enough. At those same auditions in Los Angeles, Bao Viet's father was extremely proud his son was living out the American dream. That dream ended today as Bao Viet got cut. Earlier in the week, Jasmine Ortega told us why she should be the next idol.
I think I should be the next American Idol because, of course, I'm different. I love to sing, and I would love to touch people's lives.
She certainly touched our lives, but unfortunately, she won't be the next American Idol. Meliana's group spent nearly all day apart. Now the three of them will be leaving together. That also goes for Lana Phillips, whose memory loss sealed her fate. Up until today, one of Simon's favorites, Michael Cowan, has been doing really well.
'Cause you make me feel so brand new.
So it was a huge shock when he got cut.
I'm sorry to say you're going home.
All right. I got an excellent remark from you, especially in New York City. You told me that I had sang one of the best versions of your favorite song.
I remember.
And I thought that you thought I had a great voice, you know. I know you don't give out too many of those.
You did get this far.
I know, I understand.
Today, I don't think you stood out.
All right, I will definitely see you guys next year.
As Michael left the stage dissatisfied, 57 grateful survivors returned to the hotel to prepare for tomorrow's final solo performances.
I made it. I'm very excited about that.
Ready for the next round tomorrow.
I will see you tomorrow. Have a good night.
Some went straight to bed.
Ready to go take a long 8-hour nap and be ready for tomorrow's performance.
Others had energy to burn off. And then some. Either way, they would all need to be on top of their game in the morning. After the break, the final performances.
Whoa, in my dreams I'll always see you soar above.
On stage.
Thank you.
And off.
Oh, sometimes on the crowded street.
We'll be right back. the final day, and most of the contestants are feeling confident.
I'm feeling really competitive today.
I'm ready to go in there and show them what I can do.
What do we think? Changing up the look. Hope it works.
That sentiment would apply to everybody who arrived at the theater. Each of them knew that today would be the biggest day of their lives. They had survived this far. To fail now would be disastrous. Today was about them. There was nowhere else to lay the blame. They would take the stage live and alone. Earlier this morning, the contestants drew numbers out of a hat. Now, the number they drew is the order in which they will sing.
46.
Every big talent show that I've ever done, my whole life, I've always had to perform first for some strange reason.
So many people use your name in vain, yeah.
This wasn't your best today, man. You started off a little shaky. I think it's the first time I've seen you let the nerves get to you, baby. Appreciate the effort.
I agree. You were a little bit nervous today, and it is the first time that I've seen you nervous.
Yeah, I'm going first.
I know. Nervous, yeah. It's always that way, but good effort.
That was your worst performance we've seen from you in the competition so far. And I'm surprised, bearing in mind this is your chance to shine. Thank you.
In my dreams I'll always see you soar above the sky. And in my heart there'll always be a place for you for all my life.
Just good. It's just really
Thank
good.
You so much.
I see such a great part of a performer in you, and I really like you a lot.
Thank you, Paul. I appreciate it.
Next up is Leia Vladowski.
Not having my family in America, but immigrating here and coming here, to be an American Idol would just be everything that my parents, like, came here for.
You knew how I loved you, but my spirit was free. Laughing at the questions that you once asked of me.
Thank you.
Very nice voice. Very good.
I love your voice. I love the tone of your voice. You got a real soulful vibe about you. I really like you.
Leah, you are very lucky you have Paula and Randy on this panel, because I don't like your voice.
Ooh, that was weird, I guess.
I will love again, though my heart is breaking, I will love again, stronger than before, yeah. I will love again, even if it takes a lifetime to get over you. Heaven only knows if I'm true to myself, nobody
Thank you.
Else.
You know, you've been pretty consistent. You can definitely sing. I would just make a point is to choose songs that take you as far away and don't allow you to go as close to the whole Broadway theater thing as possible. But you can definitely sing.
When we first saw you, you were, you know, racing around on a scooter, shouting out to us, I'm Scooter Girl. Now you're on the stage with quite a painful song. And if I was watching you for the first time, I would think you're boring.
Your voice is star quality. It's the imaging, yeah. And it's hard.
Look, you
this
know what?
Hard.
Hang on. At
it's
this
hard.
Point, the advice is over. Okay?
I didn't feel like you gave me any advice. You said the advice is over?
Well, the advice is over now, because otherwise we're going to be here for the next 10 hours.
It's finding your image and creating that image and sticking with it.
Well, if I can do left and right, I can do left of center.
Yes, you can.
That's good.
Yes,
See,
you can.
There you go.
Hopefully when I make the top 32, when and if, I will take what they give me and try to define an image for myself.
I'm a man of many wishes. Hope my premonition misses. But what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide. 'Cause the always stars. us to cry.
Thank you.
Good job, Erskine.
Thank you, man.
Good job, man. Good job. You did your thing.
Erskine, I just, you know, you make me smile. Today, for me, it was one of your best.
Erskine, yeah, I think what we do like about you is the fact that every time you come on, you make the effort to separate yourself from the pack.
Have to.
You have to, exactly.
You got a great attitude.
So you did good.
Excellent, well done. Dude.
Thank you very much. I feel on top of the world right now. I really do.
Your voice is warm and tender. A love that I could not forsake. 'Cause I'm your lady, and you are my man.
Thank you.
Excellent. Very good show of control with your voice. And that's one of the things that singing's about, showing that you got control over the instrument.
Thank you very much.
After some great performances, not everyone got the thumbs up from the judges.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Kansas City, Missouri, please put your hands together for Marcus Butts.
Kansas City, Kansas City, Kansas City.
If I were in Vegas, I would love it. Idol for me? Nah, not working for me, sorry.
Your image, Cassie, is absolutely horrific. I mean, you look like you dressed in the dark.
In the dark.
You're lucky we're not going to judge you on your outfit.
You don't like it?
You look like you should be something you'd wrap a turkey in.
Took it off.
I'm sorry.
Jennifer Hudson wrapped up the auditions with one of the few lighthearted moments of the afternoon. Then it was back to business as Simon addressed all the contestants before the judges' deliberations.
Yesterday was without question the worst day I have ever witnessed judging this competition. It was a disgrace. It was so bad I didn't want to come in today to judge it. However, today has been very different. You've basically done what we've asked you to do. You've raised the game.
And it's amazing.
Some of you are going to find yourself in the finals who under normal circumstances wouldn't.
With nothing more to say but plenty to discuss, the judges left to make their decisions. After the break, who stays and who goes?
I think I'm going to get cut. I think I'm going back to the islands.
Now the judges have made their decisions. They've split the contestants up into three different rooms down this hallway. For two of the rooms, they're in. But for one room, the journey ends tonight. In room one, the contestants anxiously await the judges' decision, giving them the chance to reflect on the last 4 days. Matt Rogers is as nervous as everyone else.
I'm nervous. I haven't felt like this since like 3 years ago, the night before the Rose Bowl game, man. I could not sleep at all last night.
Earlier in the week, Matt experienced the judge's disappointment.
I don't get the feeling that you're taking this seriously.
Tell me you don't like my freaking song, but don't tell me I'm not working hard enough when I'm one of the only freaking people that memorized everything and nailed everything.
John Stevens, the young crooner, has had a tough time with his memory. Will the judges remember how good his voice is?
When I come home to you, San Francisco, your golden sun will shine for me.
My prediction is that I'll be cut. I do honestly believe that I'll be cut tonight.
Lisa Wilson had much to contemplate.
If I forget the words, I am terribly sorry because it seems to be in the water.
It wasn't the only thing in the water. She certainly looks the part, but does she have the confidence?
Yeah, I'm very aware that there's other people here that are better singers than me.
Oh, we know that.
I do feel like I can do this. I have.
Yeah, but you've got to start believing in yourself. Because if you don't, we won't.
John Peter Lewis has coped really well with being dubbed a pen salesman.
I just want you to know, Simon, that
I can sell more than a pen.
Oh, baby, give me one more chance to tell you that I love you. Won't you please let me back in your heart?
I'll sell it to you, Simon, for cheap. I promise.
Thoughtful and quiet now, but the Roman brothers came ready to battle each other.
I'm not gonna let him win. If I have to, I'll cut his throat.
Now they're in the same elimination room, so it's gonna be double success or double failure.
If this is the end, it was good while it lasted.
Will it last? They'll find out now.
How you feeling?
I'm nervous.
It is down to me to break it to you. And I'm sorry that you're all seeing us again in January.
That's right, we're the first siblings to make it, baby, so watch out.
Celebrates, two more rooms await the judges' decisions. They, like you, will find out after the break. Don't be 19 people have made it through to our finals. Two rooms still await the judges' decisions. In contrast, the atmosphere here is obviously far more subdued as the contestants wrestle with their thoughts, raking through the memories of the last 4 days. In room two, it's hard to recognize George Huff without his usual beaming smile.
Here in my heart,
although there was never any mistaking his voice.
Never want to give you up, never want to let you down, never want to turn around.
But the judges have always felt that he looked too old.
I like the fact that you put the hat on, man. You try and make you look a little younger.
You
got the bees jumping on.
I'm young.
Ever the optimist, he's not giving up hope. But from the looks of it, Sarah Silva has...
In my dreams, I'll always see you soar above the sky.
Thank you.
Was it something Simon said?
You remind me of Kelly Clarkson. You really do, Sarah. Except at the moment, you just, personality-wise, disappear. The only time I remember you is when you sing.
Will the judges remember her come decision time? For the moment, at least, Alan Richson is not trying to hook up with a female contestant. There's been little doubt where his mind has been during the week. Perhaps if he'd focused on his own performance as much as he'd focused on Lisa, Brittany, Ashley, Kelly, and Heather, he would be assured of moving on. But don't forget, he started by wooing Paula. He'll definitely get one vote. Nicole Thierry stands apart from the group, which in fact is what she did in New York, where the judges loved her.
I agree with Paula. I think you have a great voice.
Hated the scooter.
Well, I presume the scooter goes if you go through.
Well,
to the next
round. The scooter was a gimmick to get me in here, and it got me in here quickly.
You didn't need it.
This week.
Myself, nobody.
Thank you.
They loved her.
Your voice is star quality.
Missed the scooter.
When we first saw you, you were, you know, racing around on a scooter, shouting out to us, I'm Scooter Girl. Now you're boring.
No wonder the poor girl is confused.
One day it's you're too wacky, you're too silly, and the other day it's too serious. So, finding happy medium.
Is it too late for Nicole? She'll find out now as the judges arrive with their decision.
Hello, gang. So, you know, first I want you to give yourselves a round of applause because this is one of the best days we've had. Truly, truly, truly. But you're not going to be one of the ones going through. This is the end of the line.
And in those few words, their world falls apart.
Nice to meet you all. Thank you.
All
right. I did everything you asked.
All their hard work and talent has not been recognized. And the dream of becoming the next American Idol is over.
This is the end.
But it's not the end for room three. A diverse group awaits the news in the final room, the bubbly Amy Adams. The fun-loving Jennifer Hudson. The straight-up Fantasia Barrino. And the brooding loner, Brie Garcia.
Hey, guys. How y'all feeling?
Well.
I'm not gonna stretch it out anymore, because congratulations, y'all.
Now that the judges have completed their selections, let's check out your final 32. Well, here they are. The judges have made their choices. Now, America, it's all up to you. Your next American Idol is on this stage. Who will it be? We'll soon find out. The voting starts next week. Good luck, you guys. Good night, everybody. Good night. Next Tuesday, meet your first group of eight. Fantasia Barrino, Diana DeGarmo, Jennifer Hudson, Mark Lynch, Matthew Metzger, Ashley Thomas, Erskine Walcott, and Katie Weber. We'll see you then.